Ireland, this is your bap. Your head is your bap, and it gets chapped.
Are you aware of the curtain?
No.
Big in the 90s, you get the curtains.
Oh, gosh.
What do you call the curtains? When you get your, you can call them bangs, the fringe.
Fringe.
And you just open up the curtains.
That's so funny. No, I've not heard that.
I used to look after my hands so much.
You did?
Yeah. Because I figured it was important in my career. And then I lost sight of that.
You know, like, you're wearing gloves. I guess people in Austin don't really wear gloves, it's not that cold.
Yeah, I know.
But like,
about
cotton gloves, and you bite them, you know, to take
them
off,
yeah,
or something.
Oh, yeah, and it's that cotton, like... Yep, I know what you're talking about.
It gives
about.
Me that feeling on my spine. Oh, this is the weirdest feeling in the world.
When we were 18, 19, we all moved to London together.
Uh-huh.
We lived there together for like a year and a half, maybe.
In London?
Mm-hmm. So then before we made our last record, we moved in together again in Glasgow, up in Scotland. Since then, we've all gone our separate ways. Like, we kind of drove each other crazy. You know, 24/7 together on tour, and then when you come home, there's still no escaping each other. Yeah.
And you guys were just in South America, right?
We were just in Brazil, Argentina, Colombia, and Chile.
And there's like 100,000 people at the show, something ridiculous like that?
One of them was 80,000 in Brazil, Sao Paulo.
Mm-hmm.
Which is pretty crazy.
And how many people?
80,000, apparently. I mean, I never know where they get these statistics
how
from.
How do you count?
They just weigh them as they come in the door, I think.
Is that someone's job?
One, two, oh.
Three, you get to 12, you gotta start
moving.
Over again.
I feel like sometimes festivals, it doesn't really feel like people are really there. Because they're so far away.
Right.
It's kind of like, you just see a sea
surreal.
Of people. You know, you just sort of see tons of...
faces. It's like staring at an ant mound. There's just so many people that you can't really focus on one.
Yeah, it's like probably more nervous playing here where you can actually see people's faces. And
festivals are kind of, in essence, are completely the worst idea for live music. Let's get a load of bands fly in using not their own gear, not having a sound check, and we're going to just put on as many as we can.
Mm-hmm. From all different genres
of
music.
From all different genres. So you have a lot of things to worry about. You're like, this isn't even my bass amp, and you're going, this sounds all very weird and strange. But, you know, it's fun.
Do you guys miss the days of playing the small clubs, or are you happy to be done with that now?
Happy to be in a place now where we can play venues that are big enough to bring in, like, fun production.
Right.
You know, like, it's nice to have a light show. I think that's really become part of our show now.
When do you start working in the pyro? When you start burning shit up? When are you going to set shit on fire? When does that happen?
It won't happen soon enough.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, I'll get to work on that.
I am sort of in the process of going London to Portland. Yeah.
So what made you choose Portland?
I fell in love with it the first time I went there, and which was to play a show. And then I came back another time, and I fell in love with it even more. What I love most about it is just everyone there is so nice.
Yeah.
I don't think I've been to a city where people are so nice to you. They're new hands. It's still a little sticky, but
wow.
I hope I can still play guitar tonight. These are so soft. It's been 12 years building up calluses on these babies, all to be taken away in 20 minutes.
They look great, don't they?
No colors?
You don't put stickers on a Ferrari.
Good?
Yes, very good.
All right.
Do you feel a little more cleaned up, a little more human now?
Yeah, confidence. Is that a thing? Yeah.
Is that a thing? Confidence
I'm pretty sure confidence is a thing. Did you get your hair cut too?
I didn't, no.
You didn't get your hair
but
cut?
But I had enough. I've got enough buffer and stuff on my hands. I think my hands are flammable.
Oh, did you get a manicure too?
He didn't. Look.
No, look at the difference. This is it.
I have beautiful hands myself.
Wow,
so.
You really do?
So, well, it comes
you
from
really do
years of
hands.
Hard work. I mean, obviously you guys have had worse radio promotions. Is this one of the better ones where you get to pamper a little bit? What's the worst one that you've had to do?
There was one time we did one, and the radio station was just in someone's house, and they had lots of cats, but we just had to be there. That was the worst thing, but we just had to be there and play a couple of songs, but it was just cats.
Cats in a house.
Everywhere.
In a radio station.
Disgusting.
I'm allergic to cats as well, so
I
was trying to, we were trying to do an interview, and I'm like, swelling up, like, yeah, and like trying to play, and it was horrible.
Hey, it's Two Door Cinema Club, and they're coming to a town near you, getting manicures and pedicures. That's my phone, Naughty. Can you get that, please? This guy calling me, it's my mom.
Maybe someday you'll be someday.